the people we know are dying day by day. And this is not the only fact that saddens me. What saddens me further is the fact that humanity has become its own enemy. The people are charging so inflated prices for medicines. They are black marketing oxygen and whatnot. The people are taking undue advantage of this grave situation. Suppose, just suppose, I hope this does not happen with any of you. Just put yourself in the person's shoes who is suffering at the very large. And just suppose then somebody does this to you. If somebody's like selling you the medicines at the higher price, then how will you feel? At this particular pandemic, we should be each other's support. We should empathize with each other, and we should support as much as we can. A simple WhatsApp text, a simple forward, a simple video call, like you can support people around you like anyhow. You just need to be more empathetic, place yourselves in their shoes, and we should all be supportive of each other in this worst pandemic time. So that being said, I would now like to state the mission statement that we here at Toastmasters provide the positive and supportive grooming environment, which allows members to develop their public speaking and leadership skills, which in turn results in greater self-confidence and personal growth. And certain ground rules, I would like to say that the mics should be on mute. I see many people have on their mics, so please kindly switch them off. Parminder, you too.
Thank you, sir.
Yapa, you also please put your mic on mute.
Sorry.
Okay. So, and the video should be on at all the times. I see still many people haven't on their videos. So can I request people to please on their videos? Pavita, Himanshi.
I'm not well right.
Okay, so Abhilash, Sunil, Charu Gulati, please on your videos kindly.
So
Yeah.
I'm joined today as a guest. I'm Charu Gulati. Also, I'm a former member of this club. I've just attended as a guest today. So
Worries. And also the main rule is that cross talk should be avoided. So, with that being said, I would now like to call upon the stage our beloved president of this club, and she is also a very passionate DTM. So, ladies and gentlemen, please help me welcome Toastmaster Madhu. Please give a huge round of applause.
thank you, Toastmaster Siddharth. Good morning, everyone.
Good morning, Madhu.
Good morning,
Good
Madhu.
morning.
Good morning, everyone. So, I have one question for you all. Like, if you had one gift to give yourself, what would it be?
Discipline.
Okay, more answers.
Bilash, I was going to answer the exact same thing.
Okay. So what about others?
Building more fitness.
Nice. No more answers, I guess.
Punctuality.
Very nice. So it could be.
And I could help others in their worst situation. So
40.
if I could.
So for some, it would be more money, more better relationship, or simply more inner harmony, isn't it? Like,
Brother.
okay, brotherhood for Toastmaster Parminder.
Yes.
A peaceful life is yours when you remove ego and desires completely and visualize yourself as a peaceful being. If we look at our life as a series of it is a series of experiences. We will appreciate the importance of our thoughts and emotion as we go from one day to another. Each life is filled with numerous experiences. Some will be new for you or some will be repetitive. If we take some minutes out every day to connect ourselves and just be still, we'll be able to gain perspective and feel I would say comfortable, irrespective of what ups and downs you are going, what ups and downs which are going in your life. So just take out some time or some moment in your life every day, and you'll feel the self peace amongst you. So I hope that you will start giving out time each and every day, and will feel a different kind of experience. So with this, I would like to take the guest introduction. Guest, please tell your name. What do you do and how do you get to know about Delhi Toastmasters? Starting with, we have Charu Gulati. She recently said that she's an ex-determinant. So yes, can we have your introduction, ma'am?
So I'm Charu Gulati. I'm a chartered accountant by profession. I'm working with EY as of now. And I've already mentioned that I'm a former member of DTM. And I'm looking forward to this meeting and joining soon as well.
Great to have you, ma'am, in today's meeting. We have our ex-DTMI, R.K. Gupta, sir. Can we see you, sir?
Hello.
Hello, sir. Good morning.
Myself, R.K. Gupta. I'm the existing Toastmaster, and I will like to join the club again shortly.
Thank you, sir. I can see one more guest. Payal is there. She will be connecting soon. So, yeah, we have guest Payal with us. Ma'am, would you like? No, she is still connecting. Okay, I think that we can take her.
Sunil is there. Sunil.
Sorry?
Sunil is there, no?
Oh, yeah. We have guest Sunil with us. Sir, can we have your introduction, please? Our guest Payal. She's still connecting. I don't think so that he's there. Do we have new guest? No. Guest Payal, can we have your introduction, please?
Hi, can you hear me?
Yes, we can hear you.
I have just joined today as a guest, and especially because, you know, I'm in isolation today, so thought that's the best way to listen to you. I've been planning all my, you know, looking forward to the Sundays to join Toastmasters and hear you guys out. And I am a teacher. I'm an EL teacher, English as an additional language teacher, with British School Delhi.
So good to have you, ma'am. Now I would like to go further. I'm asking guest Sunil if he's there now. Oh, I didn't get any response. So yes, let's move to the meeting. Now I'm calling someone. I can't see Nitya Modi. Yeah, maybe he's going to join soon. We have Toastmaster Digant as our TMOD for today's meeting. Because, yeah, he's there. Yeah. Sorry, I couldn't see you. So, yes. Please put your hands together to call Toastmaster of the day, Toastmaster Digant Mittal, for today's meeting.
Thanks, Madam Toastmaster. Madam Presiding Officer. So, in today's meeting, as we all know, the theme is about questions. Do you ever imagine that what would have been the thing that would have led us to this situation? Like today we are having electricity, today we are having a fan. Today, when we have to cook, we just go to the stove, pull the lighter, and just fire is there. it's all just because of one question. Questions are those which, and not just any question, question that rekindles the creativity within us. Question that opens up the possibilities for doing something new, something unique. Have you ever seen anyone at home who is just
you plugged into your device?
Have you ever seen anyone at home just doing some worship by counting some beads, on the like garland of beads? What happens? Can anyone explain? Has anyone done that counting of beads? What we call as mala japna.
So yes, okay. I have seen it, but not performed that activity.
So I have done so that.
What? Yeah. Yeah, Mr. Digant, can I?
Yeah, you can.
Exactly. I have seen my mom, my father, early in the mornings when they get up. So they always repeating beads and wreath of the garlands. Exactly, they are very devotee about to the God and very devotions they have. Early in the morning, still before sometimes, my mom was still doing the worship. So that is good. Because of it, it's mean we always remember to the God and we always feel God is near about to us. It's in our feelings. It is in our ears, and every as we just listen about to the God, God is everywhere. So we always mesmerize God near about to us, and that is feelings of the happiness. And with it, I think all the parents in all the family, like me, like you, like all over the world, every parents exactly and senior citizens, they always give some time to the God, and that is the very important. With it, I think we always love and we always feel and we always past some moments due to which we always learning to the God and missing to the God. And that's very nice way of the learning to the God, I think, according to me, Mr. Digan.
So, yes, but what happens on a subtle level that we count the beads over there. We speak of the mantra many times. In doing so, we get bored. Logical human, general human nature. And then our mind starts to ask one question. How can it, can I make this this chanting of mantra much more interesting? And there, it starts with unique ways of having tones, and which makes it much more interesting to chant. So today in this meeting, we will all be exploring the world of these interesting questions. But before that, help me explain you the Toastmaster meeting format. So the Toastmaster meeting is divided into three parts. First part is the prepared speech section. Now, how many of you have seen a cricket match? Or how many of you have seen the debate, especially the parliamentary debate that we see? Yeah, I'm not talking about the match, the boxing match that happens over there in parliament. But I'm talking about the debate that happens. So what happens over there? The speakers who come and speak over there, they have prepared for that. The members of parliament have prepared for the specific speeches earlier also. And there they deliver their thoughts. It is not just the game of boxing happening over there. It is actually a debate that happens over there. apart from this, so likewise in prepared speech section, people who have prepared their speeches will be coming on the screen and they will be delivering their speeches then and there up to a certain time limit as per the speech objectives explained by their evaluators. Apart from this, the next section is table topic section. Now, in our childhood, we might have asked a question to our parents randomly. Mummy, Papa, how does this moon rise in the sky? So they have to give the answer spot on, because if they didn't give the answer, then we would be running after their life to get the answer. How many of you have experienced that situation? Okay. Seems that only Toastmaster Bhavita has experienced that situation. Rest of us might have been a little bit more patient with our parents. Okay. So, likewise, here also, Table Topic Master will be conducting this session, who will be inviting you, inviting the people from the audience on the stage, and they will be given a topic to speak upon then and there itself. And the last one after this is the general evaluation session. Now, how many of you have seen the situation that you have written an answer and submitted the copy in your school to the principal, to the teacher for checking? And how many of you have felt here, all is well, all is well, all is well?
It happened every single time when you submit the exam paper to the invigilator and just go out of the examination hall. It just feels like that.
Especially with me, because whenever you just steal the copy of your best friend and put your name on that and just submit it, you are at the risk of being detected. So the same thing happens. But what happens? Every question has some answer, and that is also checked. So likewise, in general evaluation section, everything throughout this meeting will be checked. No. In Toastmasters meeting, evaluation is not like a teacher's marking. It is a constructive feedback. It is a supportive feedback, because first and foremost, the dream of Toastmasters International's founder, Dr. R.C. Smedley, was to provide a supportive environment. So everything throughout this meeting will be given a supportive feedback in the general evaluation section. So speaking of the last one first, help me welcome on the screen the team that will be helping out in the general evaluation section. So first, help me welcome on the screen Toastmaster Yapa, who is the timer for the day, to explain about her role. Toastmaster Yapa.
Hello, am I audible? Hello?
Yes, you are.
Okay. Good morning, everyone. I'm Yapa. Thank you, Toastmaster. Thank you, Madam Master Toastmaster, fellow Toastmaster, and guests. Today's my role is timer. It has to remind report of every speech of the speakers. That I have a three colors, that is a green and yellow and red colors. This is the card, and whenever the speaker will is giving this speech, that time I have to raise all those three colors. The three cards, that is green one is beginner cards as well as hit cards, and the yellow card is qualified cards, and red one is target cards. As per the three sessions, four sessions we have, there is a first one is icebreaker, and second one is speech. Just 1 second, later we continue. And speech. Third one is table topic, and last one is evaluation. And there is as per description of time limit, there is a green. There is icebreaker one is 4 to 6 minutes. And main that is speech of speech. There is 5 to 7 minutes. And third one is table topic. That is table topic is 1 to 3 minutes. And last one evaluation, that is 2 to 3 minutes. And all I have to show, that is green, yellow and red as per the times it's given there. So at the end of the moment, I will present my report to Toastmaster of the day. Thank you, all of you.
Thanks. So am I audible?
Yes.
Okay. So help me welcome on the screen our next role player, Toastmaster Sonal, to explain about her role of our counter.
Thank you, Toastmaster Digam. Whenever someone speaks, then do they wonder that how many times they use the word filler words, you know, so, like, nobody count those words, right? So, and whenever someone asks us so many questions, we got frustrated. And similarly, if we use so many filler words or use you know, like, then we again got frustrated. And it breaks the flow of the speech. So I'm the counter for today's meeting. And I will note down the filler words used by speakers, various role players, and evaluators. And I will submit my report when the general evaluator will ask for it. Thank you. Back to TMOD, Digant.
Thanks, Toastmaster Sonal. Now, help me welcome on the screen Toastmaster Himanshi, who will be explaining us the role of grammarian.
I'll be your grammarian for today. So I'll be noting the good usage and some not so good usage of the language by the speaker and the role players. I'll also be noting any pronunciation mistake or any other grammar mistake.
Excuse me, Toastmaster Manshi, just wait a second. Is everyone able to hear or low volume?
Not. I'm not able to hear, Mr. Digan.
Okay. I'll just speak, like, is it the intensity of the voice or like
volume is, I think, low.
Volume. Yeah.
Yeah, I think everyone else can mute themselves once. Can everyone else mute themselves once?
I also can't hear you.
Maybe you can remove your headphones then say.
Not wearing any. I think there's a genuine audio problem.
Is it any better now?
Yeah, it's good.
So now I'll restart. So again, thanks again. Good morning, fellow Toastmasters and role players. So I'll be your grammarian for today. I'll be noting the good usage and also some not so good usage of the languages, of the language by the fellow speakers and the role players. I'll also be introducing the word of the day today, and also be notifying you with the good usage and some not so good usage of the word. The word of the day today is it's lucidity, which means the quality of expressing something very clearly. Example of lucidity is the colonel's lucidity helped him in devising the plan for strategy of attack very quickly. Also, it should be noted that the usage of Hindi or any other native language should be avoided. In case it is required, you should give a translation of the word or the sentence that has been used. I will be keeping a track of the good usage and not so good usage of the words and or language, and also be taking notes of how many times the word of the day is used. I'll be submitting the report by the end of the day. I want every one of you to acknowledge the word of the day by showing a thumbs up like this, and or you can use the thumbs up in the Zoom function also. Over to you, Digan.
Thanks, Toastmaster Himanshi. So, as we had all these three stars who will be helping us out in keeping track of various aspects of public speaking throughout this meeting, I'm moving forward with the first speech. So help me welcome on the screen the evaluator of first speech, Toastmaster Tamanna, to share with us the speech objectives of Toastmaster Tushar's icebreaker.
Yeah, thank you so much, Nigan. So Toastmaster Tushar will be delivering his first speech, that is the icebreaker speech today, under the pathway presentation mastery. The purpose of this project is for the member to introduce himself or himself to the club and learn the basic structure of public speaking. So I would like to give an all the best to Tushar and congratulations for giving your first speech. So yeah, back to Digan.
Thanks, Toastmaster Tamanna. So help me welcome on the screen our enterprising speaker, Toastmaster Tushar Garg, Long Island Iced Tea. Long Island Iced Tea. Toastmaster Tushar Garg.
Thank you, Toastmaster.
Sorry, just apologies for not specifying about it. Since our speaker is giving his first speech of Toastmaster's journey, so I would request once he finishes his speech, let's all unmute ourselves and give a round of applause as a mark of a standing ovation to mark his journey and wish him all the best. So over to you, speaker. Now you can start.
Thank you, Toastmaster Digan, for the warm welcome. So the topic of my speech is Long Island Iced Tea, the relevance of which I would explain at the end. So I was told that in the icebreaker speech, I would have to introduce myself to the club. So this giving an introduction has always been a dilemma for me. Like whenever I was told to give an introduction, I always ask God for two wishes. Like either take me back 15 years with my current knowledge so that I could have done something interesting, or make me a good liar and a good fiction writer so that I could come up with something so interesting that I get a standing ovation. Sadly, the God is always busy making the Ambanis happy. So in school, when I was in school, I was a very hardworking and a studious person. I remember like whenever there was a quiz, I would use to keep my hand raised, as I knew all the answers. So I remember one day I was crying for a very, very silly reason. The reason was that I thought that I would not be able to score 100 marks in mathematics again. So most of the students wanted to score more marks than me. My mom would in fact get calls from parents of students asking that how many hours did I use to study. So I stood third in my class 12th board examinations. So cut short, everybody had this huge expectation from me. I myself had this huge expectation from myself. So now comes engineering. So I chose electrical engineering, which going by the popular opinion is the toughest branch in engineering. So, and I hated to the core. So from the top three in school, I dropped down to the bottom 10% of the class. And we had 10 to 12 sections. My best friend in engineering, who is also my current best friend, he used to score more marks than me and he used to study very less, and in fact, lesser than me. So in short, my life was similar to the life of Raju Rastogi and Farhan Qureshi in Three Idiots. One thing I observed in school was that the students who were not very good academically, they were good in other things like sports, dramatics, music, dance and whatnot. So when we entered college, generally these people got all the attention. So now in college, I was neither good at academics nor I knew any of these things. So self-confidence down the drain. One thing I also observed that in the first year that the students who knew how to play guitar, they got all the attention. So it took me around 1.5 to 2 years to even muster the courage to pick up a guitar. But now when I picked up the guitar in third year, now suddenly everybody had become bored of guitar. So I thought that, okay, sad life, what next? Then I observed that the people who got the highest placement in campus, their names spread like a wildfire. In fact, I observed in front of my eyes that a person who got a 10 lakh placement, he became an overnight sensation in the hostel. So I started preparing for my interviews, but due to my low scores, I got my first shortlist after 3 months from the starting of the interview processes. I prepared well for the interviews and I cracked my first interview, but it was an okay job. So I thought that, okay, I didn't get the cherry on the top, but at least I got the last piece of the cake. Now in my first job, it was basically a coding job. I realized that I was not made for backend tasks like coding. I felt that I wanted to be at the forefront talking to people and giving presentations. So I decided to do an MBA. I studied hard for it and got into a good MBA college. Now at the start of MBA, I had my priorities sorted. I wanted to do well academically as well as in co-curriculars. So in MBA, there are several committees like a sports committee, marketing committee, social media committee. So I wanted to get into one of the prestigious committees like placement committee, alumni committees, since most of the members get good placements and they have the best parties and they're generally more famous. So I got into the I got into the last round for all these committees, but couldn't convert in the last round. The same process happened in the final placements also, where I got into the last rounds of the best companies that visited the campus like Bacardi, Bajaj Auto, HP, but I couldn't convert in the last round. So you get the pattern, right? Like you have someone in your friend circle who is very funny. Suppose you're friends with Biswa Kalyanrath. So he starts saying something funny and you feel that by the end of the sentence, you would be rolling on floor laughing. But that punchline never comes. So that punchline has not yet arrived in my life. But despite all these failures, I have learned a lot. Like my networking skills have improved a lot. My friend circle has increased. The managing director of my company has praised me a lot. So due to all these failures, I can take up a new thing without the fear of failure. So I would like to conclude my speech by stating the motto of my life, which is also the title of the speech, that when life gives you lemons, and most of the times life gives you lemons, aim to make a Long Island iced tea because anybody can make a lemonade. And I asked the fellow Toastmaster Grammarian that was my lucidity on point. Thank you.
So that was really a nice speech by Toastmaster Tushar. So help me welcome on the screen the evaluator for our next speech, Toastmaster Bhavita, to share with us the speech objectives of Toastmaster Madhu's speech.
Thank you, Toastmaster Digan. Toastmaster Madhu will be giving Level 3, Project 1 speech. Pathway is Dynamic Leadership. And the purpose of this speech is to deliver a speech with awareness of intentional and unintentional body language, as well as to learn and practice how to use non-verbal communication when delivering a speech. So I wish all the best, Toastmaster Madhu. Over to you.
Thanks.
So help me welcome on the screen Toastmaster Madhu, my first day on the stage. My first day on the stage, Toastmaster Madhu.
Ring, the bell rang, and suddenly my heart racing and fear rose within me. I was nervous as I started feeling sick, really sick. I ran to the bathroom and splashed water on my face. As my heart pounded against my chest, hard and loud, as I was looking into the mirror and murmured, "Oh, come on, Madhu, you can do this." Some were looking forward to this moment for ages, but not me. I freaked out every time I started imagining how uncomfortable it is to be on the stage and be the center of attraction. If it was a speech, I could manage. But repeating a scene from a movie which has already been performed by some professional actors is simply hard because we get compared to them. But somehow I need to do it because there was no choice as it was compulsory. To the assembly hall, I bent over the script on my head. Suddenly, I was tensed as I couldn't remember all my lines. Once I was there in the assembly hall, all my fear started awakening because I lost everything, my lines. I couldn't remember any of my lines. And as soon as the teacher who was supposed to judge our performance entered the cut, and the crowd quieted down and the performance began, I was still very, very nervous till the first speaker was being called on the stage. Because I just don't like being first performer and getting into the stage in the first go. But then I feel that, Madhu, you just need to get it done somehow, because I was feeling really sick and tired. And as soon as I felt this, I got to know that, Madhu, your performance has been shifted to the next day. And now I was quite happy because maybe I thought that I could practice more and deliver it up to the mark. And suddenly the bubble burst as my teacher asked us to perform the same day. I got suddenly shocked and surprised too, because recently I started relaxing my mind, and then all of a sudden she is saying, like, you need to get your performance done by today. I started feeling as if someone has hit me on my head. My heartbeat accelerated, and as I walk onto the stage, I was literally shaking. I was shaking, and I then got up along with my friend to the stage to have a good look around. When I saw from the stage, I got to know that there were 50 to 60 people on the audience, but still I was feeling very nervous. And then I started giving my introduction, and as I went on, it went on very smoothly. The first few seconds were quite awkward for me as I was delivering it for the very first time, but I found that gradually I am there into my character which I was playing at that day. Then after my performance was over, I just look at the audience and feel how much I love doing this. This was so good. And the after feeling was such that words are not just enough to explain it. I just feel
that this was the thing I was just waiting for. My friends, after my performance, cheered me a lot by giving positive commendations. And you know what I learned that day by getting into the stage is I was not very surprised by the results or the marks I got, but the experience which I received after standing in front of the audience and delivering something for the very first time is such an awesome feeling for me. What I learned is that if you are very confident enough in you, that whatever you are doing or saying is absolutely correct, then no need to be nervous at all. My friends, you must have noticed how kids get excited about anything or everything they do for the very first time. Because once you learn to walk and talk, there comes a time where you marvel at everything around you. The experience of getting done, the experience of doing things for the very first time is very different, my friends. Sometimes it is the surprise result, as sometimes the accomplishment you have received. So as a VPA, starting from SCA, then VPA and president, now I've seen myself and got to know the things which I never knew. So if not a challenge, just take at least for your experience, do something for the first time and you'll definitely see the results fulfilling. Back to TMO.
Toastmaster Madhu, time is up.
Thanks, Toastmaster Madhu. So, let's all post our feedback for both the speakers in the chat box. Taimal, may I know if all the speakers were qualified?
Taimal, I'm sorry to say, there is a grace mark 30 seconds. That's... Madhu is saying disqualified.
Madhu is okay. Just message me the timing of time taken by Madhu.
Yeah, okay, I'll text him.
Just wait a second. Till then, we all can post the feedback for our speaker or our speakers. Okay, Toastmaster Yapa, where you have sent me the timings of both of Toastmaster Madhu.
Okay. 6:40.
Okay, considering that both the okay, please tell me the timing. Time taken by Toastmaster Madhu in her speech. Please send the message to me.
Okay. Already send it.
Where? I have not seen it.
Toastmaster Digan, she has sent me the timings.
Can you send me the timing to Master Madhu? Can you send me the time?
Shall I disclose now?
No.
Okay.
Okay. Toastmaster Yapa, both are qualified.
Tusar is qualified.
Madhu is also qualified as per the timeline that has been sent to me. So let's launch the vote for the best speaker. The timing will be shared by timer in the evaluation segment. Time taken by Madhu, Toastmaster Madhu. Let's all vote for the best speaker.
I'm not able to get Aya. Madhu, I'm sure.
Toastmaster Tamanna, you have to send the vote to Toastmaster Madhu. She is coordinating the poll from my side today.
Okay, sure.
Meanwhile, Toastmaster Madhu, can we move ahead? Okay, you can end the polling. There is an icon to end the polling.
I can't see Toastmaster.
Where you have you might be seeing the polling results, right?
Yeah, I'm seeing.
And below there are two icons, two blue icons.
Share. Can you tell the relaunch polling?
No, relaunch.
I can't see.
Is there any third one, or are there only these two icons?
These two are showing.
Okay, it's okay. We can move ahead then. So, help me welcome on the stage the table topic master for the meeting, Toastmaster Bharat, to take forward his session of table topic session.
Good morning, everyone.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Guys, first of all, Good morning. Unmute yourselves, everyone, and show me your faces, everybody. That's great. I can't see Charu, I can't see Neha. Abhilash, sir. Now I'll say it again. Good morning, guys.
Good morning.
Welcome to the session where all guests are allowed to participate as well. So now, the table topic session, as I keep on repeating in every meeting, is one of my favorite sessions. The theme of today's meeting is questioning yourself, I take it in a way that it's probably questioning my own abilities, right? Fighting my own self, answering my own, and, you know, answering my own questions sometimes. So, one of the biggest questions that we're all here for is about public speaking. So I would request you all to question yourself, challenge yourself, and take the challenge here right now. Participate as much as you can, and it's for your own betterment. So now, for the first topic, I'll be calling an experienced Toastmaster, so any volunteers. Okay, I have Abhilash, I have Parminder. Okay, Abhilash, I think it's time I'll take you for the first one. So the topic for Abhilash Bhai is questioning the unspoken.
Am I audible?
Yes, you're audible. Others, please mute till then.
Okay, so the topic is questioning unspoken, right?
Questioning the unspoken.
I was just going through a street and suddenly I saw a couple fighting. And couple was fighting on a matter which was not known to anyone. there were a lot of people around those couple fighting and nobody was doing anything. And that was a complete violent fight. I could see that the male and the boy was actually hitting the girl badly. And all the people standing there were actually keeping themselves numb, doing nothing. And I have seen this multiple times. And when I was just going through, I actually intervened in that matter and asked the boy that why you are hitting that girl. And it was my courage that I actually stood up and asked this question. Sometimes you believe, you see in your society that there are a lot of things which are unspoken. There was a very small item on which they were just fighting and the boy was just beating that girl and nobody was there. So there's something which is unspoken in the society that if something wrong is happening there in front of your eyes, you're not standing to intervene, to just stand against that particular thing, particular wrong being. I also remember one time when I was going and I saw an accident happen just before me. And like people were just taking pictures, right? People were just taking pictures, making video, but nobody was there to have that casualty to just take to the hospital. And then I realized that there are a lot of things which are unspoken, which needs to be spoken. And I'm just questioning that unspoken thing. Thank you. Over to you, Tabletop Master.
I think that was quite a wonderful take on the topic. Well done, sir. So now, for the next question, I'd like a girl volunteer. So come on, guys, volunteer. Bhavita is raising her hand. Anyone else? Okay, let's have Bhavita. So Bhavita, the topic for you is breaking the glass ceiling.
I couldn't hear you, Bharat. Hello?
Breaking the glass ceiling.
Okay. So most of the time, my parents always ask, tell me that you are very small for this, or you are very big to this. And I will always say, like, when I'm small, when I'm big, like each and every day you question, each and every day when I want to have some discussion with you relating to their finance, something, I just want them to discuss with me. And they're like, you are very small to this. It's very difficult to discuss with you. And on the other hand, next day they come with some sort of advice that please give us some advice. And I'm like, what? I just want to know that whether I'm small or to make decisions with you or whether I'm big to make decisions with you. So that brings a big confusion in my mind. And most of the time I have arguments with my parents in this situation. So yeah. Over to you.
Let's have a round of applause for Bhavita. Okay, someone needs to mute themselves. I can't hear. There's some disturbance coming out. Ujwal, I think that's you. Thank you. So now, coming to the third topic. First of all, before I go further, I'd like to request that as soon as the speaker finishes up, because it's not easy to come on stage, it's not easy to come impromptu. Every time we come impromptu, I believe that we improve ourselves. So as soon as the speaker finishes, they do well, they don't do well, whatever, unmute yourself for 5 seconds, give a round of applause, and we can mute ourselves further after that. Can you all do that? Great, thank you. Now, coming to the third topic. First, who are my next volunteers? Raise your hand, guys. Have you, do we have any guests here right now today? Would like to participate? Mehika, Charu, would you like to participate?
Yeah, I think I can do that.
Okay. So let's have Charu on stage this time. Charu, why don't you switch on your camera? If that's okay.
Is it fine to give it without camera, without video?
Okay, fine. You can do that. So the topic for you is, the fun is in the journey to find the answers and not to know the answer.
Can you repeat the topic?
The topic is, the fun is in the journey to find the answers and not to know the answer.
Okay. Okay. So if I talk about my journey so far in understanding myself and getting the answer of who am I guess as of now I didn't get the answer, but understanding every bit of me, like what my purpose, what is the purpose of my life and why I am here. So every time I think of this question, there is an unfolding answer for understanding myself for that. So every time I think of this question, I get an answer like, oh, I can do that as well. That further I understand some of my things which some of the things which I cannot do as well. So in the process of understanding myself, I get to know my strength, my weaknesses. So that is very joyful and fun to have that journey. I guess that's all for now. Over to you, Bharat.
Well done, well done, well done. It's a good attempt, ma'am. And I hope you keep improving just like this. So now, for the next topic, I need two volunteers. Please, guys, raise your hands. All those who want to participate. Okay, one is Mohit. One more, guys.
Pratik Gupta sir has raised his hand.
Okay. I think I'll need a girl on this one this time. So one is Himanshi.
She has raised.
Okay. So, Himanshi, your topic is Himanshi and Mohit. See, you guys are basically a brother and sister. And just to be able to choose your own particular career choice, you need to first convince your brother for it, and then he, so that he can help you convince your family for it. So that is your situation. And I think we should begin.
Before starting, can you please confirm that my voice is audible?
Yes, it's audible.
Okay, yeah. Great, awesome. So, okay, I'll start now. So Mohit, I want to become an astronaut. So I wanted to confirm with you first and tell you first before going to our parents, so that like it's easier to convince them also. What do you think about that?
I think it's fascinating. It's even out of the box what you're thinking, but then I just wanted to know, have you inquired enough about it? Have you done your basic research? What all you want to need? What are the prerequisites to it? What all the entire process will be looking into, and how you want to shape it? Have you inquired? Have you attained good knowledge about it? I want to know that before we discuss about this.
Yeah, so I have seen Big Bang Theory and there Howard is an astronaut. Like, he's not doing much, like, lot of good work, but yeah, still, he's cool in that way. He knows a lot. There's Sheldon also, like, he knows a lot. But I have also researched a little bit on this. So I need to, first of all, get my engineering done in some, maybe in astrophysics or something. And then I need to, you know, work on some project of mine, showcase it, maybe apply to NASA or anything. My grades are not good right now, which I can work on. But yeah, this is something I dream of doing. But again, like, it will require a lot of money. So need to convince our parents first, right?
I remember you watched some series before this and you wanted to become a lawyer. Is it the same confusion you still have?
No, that was different thing. That was Suits, right? So no, not like that. That guy, like, didn't even have a Harvard degree and he just got into, you know, becoming a lawyer and all. No, not that. I want to follow proper.
But you wanted to become Harvey Specter. I remember he has Harvard degree.
But no, like, I don't like that person a lot. So I don't want to, like, become like him. So I want to be like Sheldon, or I want to be like, you know, not howling, but Sheldon is the, you know, person I aim for right now. So I'll be studying for that. I'll be becoming like him.
Hey Manshi, you are my younger sister and I have been seeing for long now. Every time you watch a series, you want to become like that. So I think we should hold on before we go to our parents. I think it's good time. You have your lockdown, you have your Netflix. Either you disconnect your Netflix and Amazon Prime connection and then be thoughtful about your career choice. Otherwise, just wait and watch another series. Another series is coming up. Let's see if you want to become cop or you want to become some doctor in future. I think you still have time. Let's wait for it.
So I watched it like what, 1 year ago. It's still the same. Suits was when I was young. Like, I was like 13, 14
years. 2 months back.
No. You don't remember. I watched it long time ago. So I watched this just like last year and still, like, it's same. So that's why there's a continuity in that. So that's why I'm telling you, like, I want to become an astronaut. And I want to convince you before going.
I'm thankful to God you're not watching any criminal series. Otherwise, you may want to become a serial killer or something. So let's wait. I think we should wait.
It doesn't work like that, Mohit. It doesn't work like that. See, there's a trend in what I'm aspiring for. You see, like, I'm trying to become a better person, not a, you know, murderer or anything. Why? You are my brother. You should at least know that, right?
I'm your brother. That's why I know your habits, your mindset. So I think we should wait.
Let's continue. So
yeah.
Let's wait then for just 4 days. Yeah, let's see.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Wonderfully done, guys. Wonderfully done. I just hope you don't, go and see something stupid again, like, in the next 1 month. Let's then change your topic. Maybe not. I hope you don't become a, let's say, next time she's going to be a police officer, maybe, according to Mohit. Okay. The next topic, I'll pick R.K. Gupta, sir.
Yes.
And so your topic is, fear and courage are two sides of the same coin.
Fear?
And courage. Two sides of the same coin.
Fear and courage are actually two sides, because if you are not having the fear, then you will not make the efforts. Actually, if you are having, there are different type of people. Some are having little stress, some are having no stress, or some are having full stress. The persons which are having little stress are successful in life because they fear, they have some fear, and that fear converts them to do something, and they have courage. Then they have courage. You can see the illustration of West Bengal elections. Mamta was stressed due to highest efforts made by BJP government. However, this stress turned to courage and she fought the elections with full courage, with full enthusiasm, and the result is that when there were entire cabinet was sitting in West Bengal, 9 chief ministers were there, but she could win the West Bengal elections. That's why it is my perception that fear and courage are things of same quality. Over to Bharat.
That was quite nuanced, sir. Thank you. And I just got to know, I hadn't checked the news, that Mamata Banerjee has won the West Bengal election. That's also great. Okay. So, TMOD, do we have time for more speakers today?
We can, Toastmaster Bharat, we can.
Okay, we can go on. So for the next speaker, who are my volunteers? Guys, I'll have to, okay, Parminder has been asking for a long time, guys. Let's have Parminder. Next will be Tamanna, okay? I think both of these are. So for Parminder, because the topic for you is deciding who I am, Parminder.
I'm audible?
Yes, you're audible.
Okay. Yeah. My God. Many times we always ask exactly who am I? And it's very tough that how we give that explanation. It's not an easy task. It's very tough because anything can happen at any times. Now in this COVID-19, which situation is going on? People always think about to themselves, they will do something in their life and they will get so many achievements. They have so many aspirations, expectations, but everything is going to opposite. Unexpected is going on. It's means that what we can expect, it means that it is going opposite of that. So really it's very tough, exactly how we just want to explain to ourselves what we have to do in our life, what we have to do, that is not an easy task because anything can happen at any time. So it is always thinkable that not happen. So this is what, if we think about today, it's mean that today we have to make our better. Never think about the future like a miser person. So miser person always think and save the money for the future. But even then, what happened? Anything can happen. So in this situation, exactly what we have to do? It's mean that we have to think and we have to make the future for today. If we want to do anything, it's mean that today we have to think about it, that what is right, what is wrong, what we have to do. Today we have to support to the people. Today we have to do some struggle and hard work. And what is our struggle, life, competition, struggle? It's mean that we must be think about to that. And if we think about to it, so really guys, it's mean that we can easily identify to ourselves and what we want to do, what we have to do. It's mean that we can also get the achievement in that. So that's why it's very important we identify to ourselves exactly what is our job, what is our task. Nowadays, exactly, we just support to the people, like what's going on nowadays, oxygen is not. So in this situation, I think yesterday, I got the one news, people after using the cylinder of the oxygen, but even then are not returning. So what is this? What the hell is going on? So same happened with it. It's mean that if we think about to us and we think about to others. So in this situation, exactly, we can also identify and support to the people. So over to you, Mr.
That's a very good attempt, Parminder. And now, going forward, I'd like to request the timer. I do fear that there is a problem that when sometimes might not be visible to the speaker that about the cards being shown. Are we not sharing the screen this time? I realized why is that? Is that something we've changed? I'm sorry, I didn't realize it. Digant, are we not sharing the screen this time? Yapa, can we share the screen to... Because I believe when the speaker is speaking, I don't think it's visible
yes.
to the speaker.
Yes, Bharat, I was getting sister of the problem. I couldn't find out the cards.
Sorry?
Yeah, sometimes when the speaker is speaking, this particular card in Yapa screen might not be visible to the speaker.
It's not visible. Card is not visible.
I have to specifically, you know, come and switch to the gallery view to view it. Otherwise, the speaker, when they see it, they might not be able to see it. Can we do it? Can we change this thing right now? Is that possible? I think we use the screen sharing option every time, right? Madhu, can we do it?
We used to do, but it will take me some time to do.
Okay. So, guys, let's, for Tamanna, why don't you switch over? Where's Tamanna? Okay, Tamanna, why don't you switch over to the gallery view so that in your speech you can realize when the card has shown. Okay?
Yeah, it's in gallery view right now.
So now, topic for Tamanna is conquering my fear. Conquering my fear, Tamanna Bhatia.
Thank you so much, Bharat, for giving me this topic, because this is something that every day I wake up, this is something that goes on in my mind. How do I conquer my fears today? And I feel that this is a question that we all ask ourselves day in and day out. For some, that fear may be simply just getting over the fear of public speaking, like for which we are here today. For some, it may be deeper, but for each and every person, there are some fears that they want to conquer in their lives. And when we want to conquer those fears, the first step I feel in conquering those fears is accepting that, yes, I am fearful about this thing. Or yes, I am a bit intimidated by a certain thing in my life. Because only when we first accept it, do we get the courage to take the next step. That is to decide, what do I want to do to get over this fear? So for me, I would tell, my fear was participating. Yes, in my school days, I used to be very good at everything, in my studies, in everything. But as a result, I used to participate a lot in various extracurriculars. But as I started growing older, the type of competitions, they started becoming tougher, and naturally it would be. But I also started losing. And when I started losing those competitions, my confidence, it plummeted. And that is why I just stopped taking part in any competitions itself, because I felt that if I couldn't win, that would actually make me look like a loser. But recently, just because of this club, I have been able to get over this fear when I finally was able to participate once more in the international speech contest in table topics. And that is the way I thought to myself that it's okay. The only goal I set for myself is just participate and I'll be proud of you. And that is what made me come forward and actually participate. So that is my story of how I conquered my fears. And I would request that everyone should give that a try, because nothing feels better than conquering your fear. Back to Bharat.
We're all proud of your achievements at ISC and all the competitions, Tamanna. I'd really like to mention it again. Your first attempt, it has been wonderful. So, do we have time for more? I can go on with topics, guys. Digant, Tamanna, Digant and Madhu, you need to inform me. Do we have time for more?
We can take one more.
Yes.
Okay. So, all those who haven't yet participated, guys, raise your hands. I think Avita has not participated yet. Tushar, Yapa is left. Mihika is left. Sonal is left. Guys, come on.
We have Toastmaster Piyush also with us.
Piyush, come on. So, all those who want to participate, guys, raise your hands. I have one topic left.
Mihika Gulati wants to...
Okay, Mihika is here. So, Mihika, your topic is the journey of my happiness. The journey of happiness, Mihika Gulati.
Yeah, so I believe that happiness starts from us, and happiness is something which comes from inside. We do not have to wait that something will happen and then only we will be happy. So for me, like 2 years back, two of my best friends left me. So from there, I understood what actually happiness is. I thought when they'll come back, only then I'll be happy, and then I'll be able to understand. Then I'll be able to focus on other things in my life. But after some time, I realized that happiness is not that we are waiting for something to happen, but it has to come from inside. We need to understand that at this present moment, things won't happen the way we want, but we have to understand that how I can deal with this situation in a good life state and in a happy life state. Because people feel that I do not have this, I do not have that, I do not have this, then how can I be happy? There are so many challenges, so many problems. But we need to, you know, create happiness at that moment. So some fashion blogger had shared once, which I think is an example. Like she said that she when she started with her journey, she was she had like 1 lakh followers. She thought once she will reach 5 lakh followers, she would be happy, and then she would be able to enjoy this. Once she reached 5 lakh followers, she was not happy then also. Then she thought that I need 7 lakh followers now. Then once she reached that stage, then she was targeting for 1 million. She realized that she was never happy. She did not enjoy the journey. Once she reached the target, then she realized that I should have enjoyed that moment, enjoyed the journey, rather than waiting for the end result and waiting that once I reach the end result, then only I'll be happy. So we need to create happiness at that present moment, and rather than waiting that things will happen and then only we'll be able to, you know, be happy. Yeah, thank you.
Wonderful attempt, ma'am. So now, guys, it's time for me to end the session. I hope you all enjoyed it. And congratulations to all those who've taken the stage for the first time, or maybe the 100th time. You have each of you have improved something in yourself. So best of luck. And now it's over to the TMOD, Digant. Over to the TMOD, Digant, to carry the meeting. Okay, I think the guy is not available. Till then, you guys want one more topic?
We can have the polling.
Yeah. Let's do the polling and let's get the feedback from guests, I believe. So that will be the right place where we can just get the feedback from our guests, how it is going as of now.
Okay, let's do that. I will ask all the guests. So we can start with Meka. Meka, would you like to give us any kind of feedback for the meeting? Do you like the meeting so far?
Digant is over there, yaar. I'm seeing Mr. Digant.
He just came by. Let me, finish with this first thing.
Yeah, so I really liked it. I really found it interesting that how so many different kinds of, we are like from different backgrounds sharing different perspectives about different topics. So like, I was like very interested in listening to everything. So like, yeah, I overall enjoyed it.
Okay, great. Since the Gant is back, I'll be getting back to the other guests, at the end of the meeting. So the Gant, over to you.
Thanks. Can we have the poll for best table topic speaker? Meanwhile, can we speed up, Madam Presiding Officer?
Sure.
Okay. So, as we are moving towards the most important section of any Toastmasters meeting, that is general evaluation section. So, help me welcome the first evaluator, Toastmaster Tamanna, to present her report. Timer, please note that time allotted is 2 to 3 minutes.
Okay. Digant, can I begin?
Yes, you may.
Okay. So first of all, I would like to thank Digan for giving me this opportunity for presenting my evaluation. And yes, congratulations Toastmaster Tushar on delivering your icebreaker. Kudos on delivering your first speech. But since it's our first speech today, I'll be focusing more on the commendation and a bit less on the recommendations. So for the commendation for you, the Toastmaster was very fluent with his speech throughout, from the very beginning to the end. He did not lose the flow of the speech, which is very appreciable because it is his first speech. And it is just the starting of the journey. And I can just imagine how much you will grow as you go on forward with your speeches. So this is your beginning. The second thing I would like to comment the speaker on is his calmness, the calmness in his voice with which he spoke throughout the speech, because of which all the participants, everyone was glued to his speech. Moreover, in the very beginning of his speech, he left us all curious with the name of the speech, Long Island Iced Tea, which he said the meaning of which he will reveal at the very end, because of which we were glued till the end to find out what was the actual meaning of that word and how would it go with the speech. Then next, I would like to commend Tushar, the Toastmaster, for the usage of phrases in order to explain various instances in his life. For example, when he explained the instance where he did not get a job in the very beginning, but by the end of the of all his placements, he finally got the job, in which he used the line that he didn't get the cherry on the top, but he got the last piece of the cake. That was really a great usage of a phrase to explain the situation. And all in all, I would just like to summarize by saying that it was a very bang on beginning, and it was great, and we are really excited to see how you go on with your speeches in the next meetings. So it was a really good job. And just one recommendation for Tushar, which I would have, is that in the very beginning, it's okay if you do not start by saying that I have been asked to give my icebreaker, because we know it is an icebreaker. You can just begin with your speech. It would give you a few more seconds in your speech timing. So with that, I would like to conclude my evaluation and pass on the screen again to Digan. Thank you, Toastmaster Digan.
Thanks, Toastmaster Tamanna. Now, help me welcome on the screen the second evaluator, Toastmaster Bhavita, to present her report.
Thank you, Toastmaster Tikan. Am I audible? Please, can you let me know? And my voice is like, because of a bit of cold and cough. Can you hear me on?
Yes, you are.
Yes, we can hear you.
Yeah. So, just... Can I start again?
Yes, I think we should start again.
So Toastmaster, first of all, congratulations to Toastmaster Madhu for presenting level 3 project 1 speech. And I'll be evaluating the speaker's speech using CRS approach, commendations, recommendations, and summary. Now, as the speaker started with a different level of energy to gasp the attention of an audience, as soon as she splashed water on her face, the way she acted, it connected the audience to know more that what happened, what will happen next. The story behind effective body language that she shared, the story behind that, how her first experience was on her first stage. So that really connected, those gestures really connected her speech. The opening of the speech was good, and the ending of the speech was also good. It dropped out with a conclusion that everyone has their own body language, and you can't copy anyone's body language because it becomes very difficult to imitate that. And secondly, you also dropped with a good conclusion that your body language can only change with continuous practice and continuous participation. Now, it becomes very difficult. You managed very well in maintaining your body language, as it becomes very difficult to maintain body language during online meetings. So kudos on that point. And now some recommendations are, just two recommendations, that in the middle of the speech, I felt that your hand gestures and your content got mixed up. Like you had more hand gestures, and I felt that you were a bit confused in your speech while deciding the hand gestures and the body language that which one you should give. So try to minimize hand gestures and use hand gestures whenever required, because it can hamper your speech content and voice and your voice and your speech content also. And the second recommendation that I would like to give is that you could have used your stage in a better way. Like when you said that as I walked on stage to deliver my first speech, you could have used some action like walking on stage. You could have done something like that. That would have made your speech very creative, and yeah, that would have made your speech very creative. So overall, the speech was very good. You achieved the goal of the purpose of speech. But if you use this constructive feedback in your speeches ahead, definitely you will become a better speaker ahead. Thank you.
Thanks for such nice evaluation by both the evaluators with such lucidity, even in these timings where health is uncertain times. Both the evaluators presented their evaluation with much more lucidity. Now, let's have the vote for the best evaluator. Tamal, may I know if both the evaluators were qualified?
Both are qualified.
Okay. Please vote for Toastmaster Bhavita as Piyush, Toastmaster Piyush, because there was some back out earlier. So please vote for Toastmaster Bhavita as Toastmaster Piyush. Shall we move ahead? Toastmaster Madhu, shall we move ahead?
Yes, we can.
Okay, so help me welcome on the screen the grammarian for the day, Toastmaster Himanshi, to present her report.
Hey everyone, am I audible?
Yes, you are.
Okay, great. So I'll start with the usage of word of the day today. So word of the day was used by two people. First one was used by Tushar when he said, was my lucidity on point? And second one was used by Dikan when he said that all the evaluators presented with lucidity. So these were the two usage. Now I'll come to the good usage and some not so good usage of grammar. So some good usage of words were accelerated, accomplishment, disclose, numb, intervene, aspiration, intimidated, and forefront. Some of the phrases and quotes that were used today were day in and day out, center of attraction, on point, and also some quotes like happiness start from us. Also, when life give you lemons, make LIIT, as everyone cannot make, everyone can make lemonade, but not everyone can make LIIT. Another one was, I did not get cherry on top, but got the piece of cake. So these were some good usage of phrases and words. Now I'll come to the not so good usage of phrases and words. So first one was, my friends cheered me a lot. So it could have been used like, my friends cheered me up. And then I see the result fulfilling. It could have been used like, I got fulfilling results or better results. Then there was a show missing to God or learning to God. So maybe it could have been used like shown devotion to the God. Then there is one incident, one example by a speaker, which is saw an accident happened before me. So since we are using saw, it could have been used like I saw an accident happen before me, not happen. Another example is I am big to this or small to this. Rather than using this, it could have been used like I'm young to understand, I'm too young or old enough to understand this. Another example is, of not so good usage is explain to ourselves. Rather than using this phrase, we can use, we could have used understand or tell ourselves. So these were some good usage and some not so good usage of words today. Now I'll give a tip on grammar. So generally when you are talking about the second person in yourself, you should always use the second person before yourself. For example, like say I am talking about Madhu and I, so I'll be using Madhu's name before myself. So I'll be using Madhu and I went to watch movies. Okay. Now I will give you two examples. One is for the use of you and me or you and I, tell me which one is wrong. Okay. So first one is Shashti and Shashti shared her books with you and I. And second one is you and me are both part of the Toastmaster Club. Tell me which one is wrong. Anybody?
First one.
Second one is also wrong. You and I should be used. So both are wrong, I believe. So first one is should have you and me, and second one should have you and I.
Actually, like first one is wrong. The reason why it's wrong, like Tushar said. So like if you want to see like if which one is wrong, you can just remove the second part. So for example, this Shishti shared her books with you and I. Just remove you. You'll be like, the sentence will become like Shrishti shared her books with I, which doesn't make sense. So you could have used Shrishti shared her books with you and me, right? In that case, if you remove you, it will become Shrishti shared her books with me. So this makes perfect sense, right? So this is wrong. Now going to the second example, you and I are going to be late. If I take an example, or you and I are both part of a Toastmaster Club. So if you remove you, I'm a part of Toastmaster Club, which is right, right? Makes sense? Okay, thanks, Vilaj, for pointing out. Now, over to you, team.
Thanks. So, just sharing with all of you, I am a polyglot. Okay, I know more than, like, polyglots are those who know more than two languages. So, I am a polyglot, and I thought yesterday night to give it a chance that let's see how Toastmasters suggest learning a new language. Can anyone guess what is the that role player which will help me out most in learning any new language? Can anyone guess?
Grammarian.
Sorry?
Active listener.
Grammarian.
Yes, it's exactly grammarian. Even Toastmasters recommends that when you are learning a new language, just join a bilingual club, because English language is there generally in a bilingual club and another language is there. For example, if I am joining a French bilingual club, I listen to speeches in English as well as in French. And there I try out speaking more in French, and there grammarian is the best friend for me in the meeting to learn more about French. So with this, I'm moving ahead with the next role. So help me welcome on the screen Toastmaster Sonal, who is the R counter for the meeting, to present her report.
Thank you, Toastmaster Digant. My report is as follows. Grammarian Himanshi used four arms while introducing her role. Toastmaster Tushar used more than 10 ums during his speech and 8 times so. Toastmaster Madhu use two times aums. There was no long pause and filler word. Toastmaster Bharat used one aums and three times so. Toastmaster Abhilas didn't use any aums, pause and filler word. Toastmaster Bhavyata during table topic speech used four times aums. Charu while in table topic speaker Toastmaster Charu used to show. Then Himanshi and Mohit during their table topic session, Himanshi used two aums and six times like and one time, you know. R.K. Gupta sir used two aums. Parminder didn't use any aums and long pause. He two times used filler words so. And Tamanna used one time aums during table topic session. Mihika Gulati used more than 10 times aums and two so, one like, one you know. Evaluator Toastmaster Tamanna used four times aums and Toastmaster Bhavyata used more than 8 times aums during evaluation session. Then while presenting her report, Toastmaster Himanshi used more than 10 times aums. So that's it from my side. Back to TMOD Digant.
Thanks, Toastmaster Sonal, for it. Just taking a cue from the thing that I shared with you all before calling Toastmaster Sonal, as I shared about the bilingual clubs, I had the recent experience about it. As yesterday night, I was attending a district conference in New York. There were a lot of bilingual clubs in US districts, and even Arabic ones, Arabic, French, Japanese, Chinese, and all of them. So Toastmasters is a vast organization. Once you step out of the clubs and stepping out of the notion of Toastmasters that we have right now, we get into the multiverse of Toastmasters like Doctor Strange. And then we get to know about the what are the possibilities lying in front of us to learn new skills. So having an open mindset is also much more important. Just like having an open mindset and a curious mind and questioning mind is important for learning more things and further development. So help me welcome on the screen the timer for the day, Toastmaster Yapa, to present her report.
Good morning, all of you. To prepare his speech of today's, that is Tatu sir, is spoken 4.47 seconds, and Madhu 6 minutes and 39 seconds, and the table topic, that is Bharat is almost spoke about 1 minute almost, and other one, Abhilasa, 2 minutes 20 seconds, and Bhavita, 2 minutes 24 seconds, Charu, 1 minute 40 seconds, Mansi, 4 minutes 12 seconds, and 1 minute 12 seconds, and R.K. Gupta, 1 minute 30 seconds, Parminder, 2 minutes 16 seconds, Tamanna, 2 minutes 14 seconds, Gulati, 1 minute 54 seconds, and evaluation, that is Tamanna, 2 minutes 22 seconds, and Bhavita, 3 minutes 10 seconds. Over to Toastmaster of the day. Thank you.
Hello.
All right, where's the guy? Is the guy not part of the meeting? I don't think he's here anymore.
Yeah, I think he got dropped.
Okay, so till then we can continue with our guest introductions, feedback. So now we can talk to Charu probably. Charu, are you here? Charu, can you hear us?
Hello.
Hi, Charu. So, we'd like some feedback from you.
The overall, the meeting was very great. The speakers, I really enjoyed it. But I think the one thing I just really want to give the feedback, I think the energy is missing for today's session. What our usual energy we usually have in our Toastmasters meeting. I maybe because of the video call forum, maybe because of that. But I think we can improve on that. Overall, the meeting was great.
I think it's probably because like a lot of members who are attending today are actually sick as well. So that's why.
Yeah, that can be one more.
Really
one
sharp, more but we'll keep that in mind.
Yeah.
Okay, guys. Energy. Okay. So, right now, Digant is still not back up. Like, who's the co-host today?
Okay, I'm the co-host. As Digant has already called all the Oxroll players, we can have the polling. And then, we can...
But please check. Maybe he's trying to join. He must have sent a request. Okay.
No, he isn't there.
Okay, we can select the best Ogre role player.
So yes, as we have finished the polling, we can also have the best role player.
Okay, let's do that.
Yeah.
Are we done with that?
Yes. We still don't have Toastmaster Digant. Till the time, can I share the results with you all?
Sure.
If he'll be back, he can further continue. So guys, you all have voted, right? But I haven't received any feedback from you guys.
Oh,
and,
right.
Can you confirm that whether you had your feedback or not?
I will be giving your feedback. I'll be watching your recording again. I'll be giving you feedback by the evening.
Toastmaster Tushar, have you received any feedback?
I have received.
Okay, nice.
Right, so, others, please give feedback as well. Yeah. If you don't give feedback, then the whole concept of it is not working correctly.
Absolutely, because we are here to improve, and if we can't find out any feedback from you guys, then how can we improve upon?
I think today people are in the a little bit lazy mood. Everybody is watching elections probably, and
Actually, I want to say something, Madhu. I don't have number of Tushar Garg. Exactly, his statement was dynamic. So I want to also give the feedback of him.
So what we can do is, in that case, we can all give feedback on the chat right now. Let's take 2 minutes and give feedback.
Yeah.
Let's just do it.
Chat.
Everybody, please do this. Give feedback to all role players, to all those who you can.
And give everyone, whether he is a TT speaker or has taken any role.
Madhu, can I say something?
Yes, Toastmaster Bhavita.
Yeah. So, like, it
it is tough times, you all know, right? We can't meet in these tough times. We can't do physical meetings right now. But what we can do is we can build energy in ourselves. So I request everyone, to laugh for a moment, and I just request everyone to laugh so that we can build that energy of Toastmasters. We can clap, that is missing, right?
Yes, we can all unmute and laugh as much as we can.
Let's laugh.
Let's show our teeth
to the best therapy.
Okay, now Abhilash has done the best thing. Let's go full screen below. Spotlight girl.
Salute everyone. Please.
Yeah,
he's a celebrity.
We can see you.
Hello.
Hello to this. Everybody see you.
So yes, we were doing laughing exercise. Are we all doing so?
Yeah, guys, laugh. If you don't have any reason to laugh, then there's some problem, because we can laugh all alone, on yourself also. That's a good therapy.
Can someone crack a single line joke so that everybody can laugh?
Yush, come on.
Yush, can you crack one joke?
He has already started thinking about it, you know?
Yeah. So I read a joke, I think, a few days back.
Just tell a single line about yourself. So one line comedy sort of things about yourself.
Everything about me is not comedy, yaar.
This is one liner, okay?
Let's start.
So there's one joke that I heard that goes like, I'm trying to organize a hide and seek tournament, but good players are really hard to find. These are puns. Mostly.
So, who are those good players? Can you just tell?
See, Bhavita, the thing about jokes is if you have to explain it, it's probably not funny.
कल मैं एक बार movie देख रहा था, तो south की movie थी, एक था खिलाड़ी, okay? So हिंदी में डब थी, तो मैं बता रहा हूँ उसमें हुआ क्या। तो उसमें एक हीरो है, मुझे नाम नहीं, नानी वाज द हीरो, और वो लोग ना एक ट्रैकिंग पे जा रहे थे, तो एक मोटी सी लड़की वो उनके साथ थी, जिससे उसके ना पंगा रहता था। तो वो मोटी सी लड़की को देख के बोलता है कि आज पहली बार देख रहा हूँ। तो लड़की बोलते क्या, बोले एक पहाड़ को दूसरे पहाड़ को चढ़ते हुए।
Is the meeting over or
no, sir? No, we are waiting for you, so we started.
Still, we are waiting for him.
Yes, you can continue to Toastmasters.
Yeah, we were missing Mr. Digant. We are looking
just
forward.
Concluding my TMOD now. Questions in military, also, this is said generally, no questions asked, no answers given. That's signifying that everything should be clear. Crystal clear. But that restricts the learning part. But that's required for the need of our, because in wartime, there is no point for much debate. Because once we start debating, boom, a shell might drop, and even the debater might not be there. So, I would say that when exploring the things, having a questioning mind is good, but it is also important that we ourselves become curious and not let the questioning mind hamper our further growth. Like, for example, if we have to explore some new course, yes, we should be questioning that. How is it possible? How it could be? But apart from this, we should also think that, okay, let me see, how is it possible? If we add this small phrase, let me see or let me explore before those questions, then those questions will not just be the questions. They will be an exploration, an inquest in itself. So I want all of us to remember and work towards this thing that in our general life, we might be coming across a lot of things, and specifically also in Toastmasters also, we might be coming across a lot of things, and we might come across a far more lot of things. Just having this questioning mind with an exploratory perception that let me see what all are the new things in Toastmasters for me, or what all things are there in a particular course or in a particular situation for me to learn from. We can actually make the best out of that thing. So questions can be a stop in our growth, but if we rephrase them, they can be the best thing that can ever happen regarding our growth. So with this, I hand over the screen back to our presiding officer, Toastmaster Madhu.
Thank you so much, Toastmaster of the day. Can we have a huge round of applause for Toastmaster Digan? Today, I would like to appreciate Toastmaster Digan for taking the role for the very last moment.
I was shocked that I think the TMOD was supposed to be someone else.
It was because he's not well. The earlier TMOD Toastmaster Akash isn't well. And hoping you all to be safe, to be on the safer side at your home. Be safe, everyone. And
Madhu, we should appreciate Bhavita and Digan both for, because they are not.
Yes, I can see that
the roles at the very end moment, so that is really commendable. I feel we should all have a round of
applause
for both.
Madhu, did we have best ox roll voting?
Yeah, we had Toastmaster Digan, and we have the clear results now.
Okay, thanks.
Yeah, I really appreciate Toastmaster Digan, Toastmaster Bhavita, and also Toastmaster Sonal, who wasn't feeling well, and she has left the meeting now. Yes, now it's a time for the certificates. So, do I know who is the best table topic speaker? Guesses, everyone?
Yes, everyone did well. Himanshi did well. Himanshi Mohit did well. Abhilash did well. Tamanna did well. There were so many good speakers.
But the winners, we have two winners today.
Oh.
The winner is Toastmaster Mohit and Toastmaster Himanshi. The topics selected were very difficult, Toastmaster Bharat, but still they conquered all your the questions. Yes, we have the best speaker. What do you think? Who is the best speaker?
Abhilash.
I didn't even. Table topic.
In no. Table topic, yes.
No.
Table topic, Megha Gulati.
Megha Gulati as well. It's a tough competition. So right. Yes.
सो रहे हो ना तुम दोनों
अभिलाष
तुम सो रहे हो यार दोनों सो रहे हो गाइस
इट वाज अ ट्रिक फ्रॉम टोस्टमास्टर परविंदर एंड टोस्टमास्टर अभिलाष टू मेक अस ऑल लाफ एंड स्माइल या
नाइस
सो आई वाज आस्किंग हु इज द बेस्ट स्पीकर
ओके
तुषार एंड मधु बोथ इट्स अ वेरी टफ कंपटीशन रियली टुडे
Okay, guys, so the best speaker is the one who is speaking now. Thank you, everyone. I'm the best speaker. Okay, so let's have the best evaluator.
Abhilash and Tamanna. And Bhavita. I forgot yet. One of them. One Abhilash. The other.
I think Tamanna.
Tamanna.
Yes, Tamanna. Tamanna. It was awesome.
So the best evaluator is Toastmaster Bhavita. Now comes the best ox role player.
Abhilash.
Himanshi. Abhilash for everything.
Abhilash is everywhere, I believe so. So just you can vote me anytime, just anonymous.
Actually, a good person always get respect. So it's mean he is good. So that's why we're looking forward everywhere, Mr. Abhilash.
So guys, the best auxiliary role player goes to Toastmaster Himanshi. Now comes the best role player. No more guesses.
Bharat.
Yeah, done last one.
I don't know who all has voted because I still got the result, but I
Toast
can't.
Master Bharat, I see.
Sorry.
I am seeing the result in my console. Should I announce the name?
I'm announcing Toastmaster Digan.
Okay. Sorry. Just I'm informing you the result.
No, I know, I can see.
Okay.
So the best role player goes to Toastmaster Bharat.
Thank you.
Great topics, Bharat. It was really interesting. Today's table topic session. The topics were amazing.
It's good to have you all on this Sunday morning.
No, we have forgotten to take pictures.
It's not over yet.
I'm just appreciating everyone who all have attended today's meeting. Yes, we can have the picture session. So I request all to be on the video mode. And Toastmaster Piyush, can you take us one for us? Toastmaster Yapa, we cannot see you.
Yapa? I think she's asleep.
Hi.
Okay, maybe.
Guys, okay, I have a request. It's like we need to, from next meeting onwards, propose some changes so that, because in the online thing, we do need to make it a little more energetic. Can we have a 5-minute break in between? Because obviously sometimes sitting for 2-2.5 hours is not easy in an online meeting. Like, we do a banter session post-meeting, but usually in the offline meetings, we had a 5-minute break in between, right? It used to recharge us. Can we do that?
Maybe yes. Yes, I'm agree with you, sir.
Okay. I think we should have some socializing time as well.
Oh,
yeah, for 10 minutes in between the meeting, we should do it so that we are recharged. Because we can't concentrate for 2.5 hours, nobody can.
Yeah.
In the meantime, what we can do is
game session.
Yeah, this is what I was saying.
Game session will definitely help. Like,
yeah, okay, let's
have activity session or something like
okay,
that.
Okay, fine. For every meeting from now on, let's have a 10-minute activity session, if that's possible.
Next meeting, I'm just taking up this role of just being a game master for 10 minutes.
Great.
Okay.
Sorry.
Let's click the photograph till then.
Ready, everyone?
Yeah.
1, 2, 3. Okay. Got it.
Thank you.
Yes, thank you.
With this, I announce the official end of today's meeting and the floor is open.
Okay, wait. Before that, okay, we have taken feedback.